Well, hey guys, good morning. Big A coming to you from the Station Camp Greenway, just like always, 4 days a week. Hey, have you guys ever met or read any of Bob Berg's material? Golly, what an amazing guy. He wrote The Go-Giver, and he also wrote The Go-Giver Leader. I've read both those books. I've had the privilege of interviewing Bob on two or three occasions. The guy's one of the nicest guys on the planet, and his books are absolutely incredible. And I want to encourage you today to go get The Go-Giver or The Go-Giver Leader. I promise you it will radically transform the way you do leadership. I want to stop for a second because I want to talk to you about something I feel is vitally important. We had a mastermind group meeting yesterday, and I want to be honest, when I got off that call, I was upset thinking about some of the things that we're not doing as men. And I want to encourage you to do this. One of the guys had a challenge to where the in-laws were interfering radically with his life. And he went through the whole scenario and he told the story. And at the end of the day, his mom was the problem. Now, this is going to sound harsh, and some of you guys are going to send me hate mail like I get oftentimes, but I got to be honest with you. I'm going to tell you something straight up that's going to wreck your marriage if you don't pay attention to it. And guys, I'm talking to you primarily. I'm talking to you exclusively this morning. So women, just sit back. Hold on. I'm talking to the men today. Guys, if your wife ever feels like that you're choosing your mother over her, you've got a disaster in the making. Now, I can promise you, and here's what you need to do. In my opinion, I don't know your mom, but what I do know is you stood before God at some point and you made a covenant with your wife to take care of her, to pledge to honor her, and you're running your life according to your mama. Now, I want to tell you, you need to sit down and tell your mom, I love you. You need to tell her she's the greatest woman on the planet outside of your wife, but you cannot run your life according to your mama. I am so grateful for my mom. My mom's never interfered with my marriage. Some of this I'm just speaking from a biblical standpoint, not from an experience standpoint. But some of you guys need to privately take your mom aside and say, listen, Mom, I stood before God and made a covenant to take care of my wife, and that's exactly what I intend on doing. And if you can respect her, and you can love her, and you can cherish her, you're welcome at our house anytime. But if you can't respect my wife, I'm just going to tell you, we're going to take a little sabbatical from our relationship. We're going to set aside our relationship because I've got to honor my wife. I've got to cherish her. I've got to take care of her. Because, guys, listen, I've been around 38 years doing this. You know, Robin and I have been together a long time. We've had our challenges, don't hear me wrong. But I want to tell you something. When your wife thinks that you think more about what your mama thinks than her, you've got trouble in the making. It's coming soon. So just mark it on your calendar. You need to get with your wife and say, I love you above all. I cherish you, honor you. I'm going to protect you. I'm going to respect you. And you've got to have that difficult conversation. But here's what happens. The least bit of conflict that arises in the family, you tuck your tail between your legs and you run because you want to straddle the fence and you don't want to take a position and you're destroying your marriage. I know this sounds harsh, man, but 55% of our marriages today are ending in divorces, and oftentimes it's because you won't take a stand to honor and protect your wife. Guys, we got to do this, and I know it's hard. Listen, it is so difficult to take a family position like that, but it's your responsibility. It's incumbent on you to protect your wife and to protect your family and show your children how you should honor and protect your wife. So listen, I know, my goodness, golly, I can't even imagine having to go through that. But not only do you have that problem, you're inviting another problem soon on the horizon if you don't take the position that I'm talking about. Get some guys around you, get great counsel, be sure to honor them. Always pray earnestly before you have these talks. Don't say it out of angry or malice. Don't say it harsh. Say it with love. Say it with respect, because the Bible teaches us to respect our parents. And I want you to respect your parents. But at the same time, we have got to stand up and do what Bob Berg talks about in being a go-giver leader. Go get that book. Get the leadership books in your life today, and it will encourage you to take that stand. So guys, listen, I know this is rough, I know it's harsh, but I know you want that relationship with your wife to be all it was intended to be. So go out there today and crush it, all right? I'm Aaron Walker coming to you live from the Station Camp Greenway. We'll see you. Have a great day.